Since way back, artificially intelligent machines were generally portrayed in movies as scary and evil, and that Terminator looks terrible. But anyway, in general, the habit has been to portray AI as the enemy and not to be trusted. However, the irony is that in order to produce most modern-day movies, VFX artists are actually using AI and machine learning tools to help them out. And with robots getting a lot more advanced, it raises the question, will AI replace actors? Well, maybe not with robots, or at least not just yet. But in many modern movies, there are actually occasions where you've been watching AI-generated material and not even realized. You see, little by little, AI has been creeping into the visual effects workflow and it now forms part of a variety of different tools. Adobe After Effects Roto Brush 2 uses Adobe Sensei Machine Learning to predict the movements of the foreground to allow you to easily cut it out from the background without spending hours and hours of tedious work. Nuke 13 also uses a machine learning toolset and Maya has neural network capabilities. Oh, and by the way, if you'd like to learn how to use Adobe After Effects from scratch in just 2 hours, stay tuned until the end of the video. Machine learning is basically this: compiling a library full of data that the tool can then use as learning data, so it can then study this data to identify patterns, similarities, or differences. So how do VFX companies take advantage of this? Well, Framestore did a research project with software developers Weightshift to combine ragdoll simulation, keyframe animations, and machine learning to take care of the more menial and repetitive tasks, like for example this man riding a horse. His body appears to be animated, but actually it isn't. His body movement is being generated by a ragdoll simulation that is reacting to the horse's animation. This then allows animators to focus more on the artistic elements of the shot, like for example having him turn around to see who's behind him, while all the rest of his movement has been automatically taken care of. You can see this technology being used in the TV series His Dark Materials on things like, for example, this monkey's tail. Weta Digital uses deep learning in its facial pipeline and also the FACETS system that can capture subtle details of the actor's performance and figure out which muscles have moved and how, and then it maps those movements onto the digital characters. Digital Domain also use their own machine learning software Charlatan with their proprietary tool Masquerade in their real-time cloth simulation tool Elbor, and for the facial capture with their real-time live drive system. As the use of AI in tools and the tools themselves expand and evolve, it seems that the only thing that limits their capabilities and effectivity is the amount of learning data they have access to. When Digital Domain had to do a digital pickup shot for Channing Tatum for Free Guy, they were very limited with the amount of quality data they had access to from the machine learning. Even so, their results were impressive. But with access to more learning data, they could be even better. Considering every VFX house has its own AI software and its own learning database, we asked Digital Domain's VFX supervisor Nikos Kalaiksidis whether a shared centralized machine learning database could be a future possibility. He told us that VFX houses could collaborate and share large datasets without exchanging them via federated learning. This would allow each VFX house's tools to learn from data another company has uploaded without actually having access to or copying it. Kind of like the difference between watching a film through your neighbor's window instead of them just handing you a copy. What does this mean for the future? Well, the possibilities of what could be accomplished with the help of deep learning and AI are immense. Some people are looking to implement it to enable audio files to drive a rig for the initial facial animation. This would give animators the basic facial expressions and lip syncing just from the actor's audio file, freeing them up to work on the more artistic side of things. It could also be used for large-scale environment generators, texture shading to speed up render times, extracting mats, adding or removing noise, grain, and texture, and 2D and 3D compositing processes like de-aging and frame interpolation. Time and money are the two most limiting aspects of visual effects. Deep learning and AI could speed up VFX work, thus allowing film producers to get good VFX faster and cheaper, or for VFX artists to spend more time on the details of an effect, thus allowing the film producers to get higher quality VFX for the same money. Let's just hope film producers pick up the latter option. Similar to what happened when robots first began to appear on the industrial factory floor, many feel that AI may be taking over jobs that humans can do, and this may be true, but the jobs the AI is taking are the grunt work jobs, the manual labor that humans find boring and repetitive, and by taking those jobs, they are freeing the artists from the mundane and allowing them to be artistic. Now, for those of you who'd like to learn how to use Adobe After Effects in just 2 hours for free, then let me just introduce you to Ruan Lotta on Skillshare, whose course will not only walk you through all the essential things you need to know, from learning the user interface right up to rendering projects, but will also teach you how to keep your projects nice and tidy, all in just 2 hours. But how can you do this for free? Well, if you're one of the first 1,000 people to click the link in this video's description, you'll get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. And once you sign up, you can spend all day leveling up your skills on pretty much anything, from movie making to graphic design, or even knitting. Whichever skill you're interested in, it pretty much has them all. So be one of those first 1,000 people to click the link in the video description and start your free 1 month trial of Skillshare today. I fully recommend it, you won't be disappointed.